Well, Brad Inglesby is an amazing writer. He wrote Out of the Furnace, which I was a big fan of. It was called The Low Dweller when I read it, and I was a big fan of that script. And so when I read this one, I immediately wanted to do it, especially because I mean, he's very good at developing these characters and the world. He really knows about the world. And initially it was set in Philadelphia, but it had every element that the movie is practically the same as his script as he wrote. And I immediately wanted to do it and immediately thought of Liam for the main character. And interestingly enough, the movie got pushed a little bit and Nonstop came in first, you know. But this was a movie that Liam and I wanted to do for a long time. He is a man looking for one opportunity to redeem himself, and I think in this movie he gets that gift, you know. Yes, it's, all that happens is sort of bad, or it looks like a big problem, but in his eyes, this is a big opportunity to redeem himself and reconnect with his son. I think the outcome of the movie is not whether he can solve the problem, is whether he can earn the right to be called a father by his son by the end of the night. So it's a deeper story than other stories that I've done before, like with him in Unknown or Nonstop, where the concept was overwhelming the characters, you know. And in this one, you have more time to kind of meet the characters and make a deeper movie. Yeah, I mean, thematically, it's about fathers and sons. It's about the kids paying for the sins of their fathers, you know, in different ways. They're both living with that persona, you know, which is their father, and how that is affecting their lives. And this whole night will solve everything, you know, hopefully in favor of Liam Neeson's son. Yeah, I think it all starts with Liam. Liam is an actor's actor, and every actor wants to work with him. The script was amazing. The characters were already very fleshed out. We needed a character to play, an actor to play Sean that was equally charismatic as Liam, so you can understand why they're friends, and equally intense. And I cannot think of a more intense actor than Ed Harris. You know, he was the number one choice for us, and he was shooting a play. He was doing a play at the same time in Broadway we were shooting this, so it was very exhausting for him, as he shot every scene in this movie on his days off from the play. So every Monday we had him on set. And when you think about casting Liam Neeson's son, you need somebody who has a great physical presence, great acting skills, and also has to be charming and charismatic, and that's Joel. You know, Joel Kinnaman is a star, and he was great. I had known Joel for a while. We wanted to work together for a long time, and it was great that he said yes to the role, you know. Yeah, that's what we tried. I think that comes from when I shot Unknown in Berlin, and after I shot the movie, everybody was like, oh, you've done a love letter to Berlin. It was kind of by accident. I was just shooting whatever I liked, but New York is more difficult because everybody knows what New York looks like, and they've seen it in movies and in TV shows. So after having lived in New York for a year doing Nonstop, I sort of get to know the city, and I knew the difference between the New York that everybody sees and the New York that people that live here see, and I wanted to capture that. And it's a snapshot of one night in New York. And the only way to do that is to shoot many nights in New York and try to capture that. That's what we did. I obviously love the characters more. It's so easy. You just sit down, relax, and let these guys do their job, and I just point the camera. Every time is a car chase, Fights are okay because they're so well rehearsed, but anything that is like the subway scene where you're dealing with trains and people and choreography, that's really painful because you have to get the timings right for the thriller aspect of it, and yet nature is fighting in you on every level. But a scene with two great actors sitting on a table, that's what I love to do the most. You know, just forget that you're directing a movie and just watching it.